Welcome to June staff picks. I've been abandoned. No one wanted to get up this morning and do staff picks. Luckily, I have a great friend here who is jumping in and going to play the characters of our staff. Haywood.
This is what's called, digging to the bottom of the wine barrel to find somebody to come in this morning. So there you go. We're here. Nice to be here.
Yahoo. Nice to write. So we're going to go through June. And so far, with the first one up, we have a Sauvignon Blanc from, as Alan would say, Chile. It's Chile. And it's actually kind of cool. It's not your cat pee grapefruit bomb.
Right.
It's a little, do you want a little?
So
she loves some in the morning.
Chloe.
It's a little kind of more citrus lemon lime. I think it's a refreshing,
and
nice.
It's not the bone dry that you're going to get with a lot of Sauvignon Blancs. It's a little more floral. And actually, even a touch of sweetness. So very pleasant. Shows up nice.
$11.
Chili from Chile. Yeah. $11.
That's good.
Great deal.
That's great.
Chloe likes it.
So up next is Left Coast Cellars Pinot Noirs from Willamette Valley.
That's Willamette. In Oregon, right?
Oregon.
There you go.
Willamette, damn it. That's how you remember that.
I got it.
It's a nice, light, soft Pinot.
Yeah, this is great quaffing wine. You can just drink this by itself, or it'll be. Be pretty good with light meals. You can do this with fish.
It actually opens up. It's actually pretty big for Oregon Pinot. I Googled it this morning. It's $26 at the winery. It's $20 at the wine bin. What a deal.
What a steal.
So next up is this little wine from Lebanon. Do you know where Lebanon is? I have no idea.
Over in the Middle East.
Somewhere in the Middle East. So we have a Middle Eastern Lebanese wine. It is Cinsault Cabernet Syrah, sees no oak. It's a oak free. Maybe they don't have trees over there.
They have trees.
Do they have trees?
Different kinds of trees, though. I think they have deciduous trees, though. But anyway, a lot of pepper. A little bit of black currant on the back.
Yeah, this is nice.
And so this is what? This is a, oh.
This would be.
Salt, Syrah, and Cabernet.
Yeah, so this would be, okay. If Chris was here, this would be his staff pick. So let me put Chris's bow tie on. Because Chris made the comment I'm going
to
actually
try to tie this.
Chris made the comment that we need to all wear bow ties for our staff picks. He wore a bow tie at the last charity thing we went to with shorts on. It was kind of
this is where we would do the musical interlude.
Am I doing this?
And Chloe, it looks good. It looks great. You're almost there, folks.
Is
amazing.
Did I do it?
That's pretty good.
Okay, so.
That's pretty good. And now you gotta do the Chris thing. Very good.
So this wine comes from Lebanon. It's really good. Was that good?
That was excellent.
Was that Chris?
Outstanding. There you go.
That's Chris. So the next wine is would be Sue's pick if Sue was here, but she couldn't get out of bed this morning. So I think you need to play Sue.
So she wears
this weird little ugly vest.
Like
it's hideous. Hideous. And then here's her little lunch purse that my daughter gave her.
And a lunch purse. Is it a wine-carrying lunch purse?
It's a wine-carrying lunch purse. She puts cheeses and stuff.
Okay,
so
perfect. So
there's
set.
Your little lunch purse.
Okay.
So Sue picked this strange little wine from, where is it? Uruguay? How you say that?
Uruguay.
So when we open the store, she introduces this man from Uruguay, and he brings in weird little wines. Although this is kind of cool. It's Tanat Cab. It's two Bordeaux blends. Sees a few months in oak. It was interesting.
Again, I mean.
It's a good wine.
Real approachable.
I was teasing
light.
Sue about it. It's actually good.
The heavy, earthy, branchy stuff that a lot of the
maybe we should apologize.
California
Sue, we're teasing you.
Nicely done.
This is nicely done.
Nicely done, Sue. I like this. All right.
Just because you couldn't get out of bed this morning.
And I think I'm keeping this. This is great.
Yeah, with the little handwritten wine bin.
Hand bin, wine bin, logo on it. Our next pick is a Zinfandel from Lodi region in California, and it's straight off. This is amazing. This is a big berry, like strawberry, raspberry nose.
It's huge.
And it tastes just like it smells. A lot of berry. Pretty dry. A little bit of that, that earth at the back.
This is from Lodi, which is a hot area. So this is $11.
That's a steal for $11. That would stand up in a blind tasting against a lot of way more expensive zins.
Straight.
But I like some of the zins have gotten so fruit forward they just choke you. This is a big fruit nose.
Nice.
But I think a pretty pretty good berry.
Makes you want to howl.
Oh,
stray dog.
Good. Nicely done.
Last up in our staff pick is this little, I should say little wine from Rioja, but
El Sacro de Oro. Sacro de Oro.
Not a little wine from Rioja. This is a big wine from Rioja.
This is a big bomber.
This would be Julie's pick if she was here. How do we imitate Julie?
Is this her sweater?
Yeah, remember. What did she say in the last one?
I don't know. No, that's
her Argentinian. That's not her Argentinian wine. I like my horses. I like my men from Argentina. What did she say? I can't remember. So this is Rioja. This sees 12 to 14 months of new French oak. It is massive. Blackberry, pepper.
This is opened up dramatically in just half an hour that it's been opened.
This is a beautiful bottle.
Big wine, but soft, ready to drink right now.
Julie always gets the most expensive too.
She's a classy lady.
This I googled this just to see. We sell it for $26. It has a suggested retail of $56. So
that's
either I've priced it wrong or
it's a great $26 bottle.
Fell off the back of the truck or something.
This is good. You want to throw a steak on the grill for this one.
These wines of this month are extremely different. Every single bottle is different. And we picked some very strange...
And it's different and good.
Strange areas.
You know why that is?
Why?
Because I've hijacked the staff
you
picks
hijacked
this
the
month.
Staff
so there you go.
You definitely hijacked the staff picks this month.
This is fun.
So there you have it. Our June staff picks. Come in, give them a whirl. Tell us what you think. If you don't like it, we'll just blame it on Haywood. It'll be his fault.
You'll love it.
So the value, I think... is about $113, and we're going to sell the six at $87 this month. So stop by the wine bin. Cheers.
Cheers.